Kan die? Welcome to.
Jezus, ben moe.
Welcome to.
Jezus.
Welcome to Introduction Masterclasses Cool Hunting by Signs of the Time, Part 3. Very short recap of what we did in the other two parts. This part will go over cool seeds and what they can mean for you and for your future and for your business. But first, a very short recap. The world is flat, which means that you have to compete in different ways. And who will win? The ones who are the most creative and the ones who are the most innovative. And our claim is that cool hunting helps. Cool hunting works like this. You get inspiring presentations, and we're going to assign you to hunt for cool seeds of new developments based on this inspiring presentation. You're going to blog about your cool seeds, and we upload that in a protected environment for the whole group. So you will not only see your own blogs, you can read all the blogs of the other groups as well. And if they are as good as you are, we really create a very inspiring workspace. And you can stand on the shoulders of that workspace. That's a leading ingredient of becoming more trend sensitive and more innovation sensitive in a methodologically sane way. Next to that, we offer you depth interviews of the best experts on the field you are going to cool hunt on. Because those experts are often for two decades or more active in the industry or the field. And that adds another layer of content. And we are making content analysis of Harvard Business Review, The Economist, Wired, China Daily, the New York Review of Books, the New York Times, the very best information channels we know of, with way more depth than what you often can read on the internet. And we read the most important book they advise us to read. So three different layers. And from these three different layers, you can start on doing your cool hunt. One example on how literature can enrich and inspire you. This is one of the books we've read by Peter Diamandis, and very simple. One quote, first a quote, and then I tell you what we're going to do with it, or what we can do with it. This is for a company called Google. How's my health this morning? One moment, says your digital assistant. It takes 30 seconds for the full diagnosis to run, which is good considering the system deploys dozens of sensors capturing gigabytes of data. Smart sensors in toothbrush, in toilets, wearables, in bedding and clothing, implantables inside your body with a 360-degree view of your functioning. Your microbiome looks perfect, Google tells. Also, your glucose levels are good. Your vitamin levels are fine, but an increased core temperature and high levels. Google, please, in plain English. Google, you've got a virus. I ran through your last 24 hours meeting. It seems you picked it up Monday at Jonah's birthday party. I'd like to run additional diagnostics. Would you mind using alphabets, blah, blah, blah? This is going to happen. All the technologies are here already. And combining all these technologies in this kind of wonderful new phenomena is expected to be realized in 2026. Interesting quote on ICT, but also on health and maybe retail and maybe automotive and certainly ICT. So this could be an inspiring quote to help you to work on, to cool hunt on. And then we get interesting outcomes. If you say to an interesting group, this is a quote, what does it mean for health? Or what does it mean for? Then, and you blog about it, that's the start of a cool hunt. We told you already, we do this with a lot of universities, about 54 during the last 10 years, and we trained 10,000 cool hunters. And this is our first try. We continue with universities because we love them, and you need fantastic people there, including professors. But this time we're going to set up a cool hunt, very international, because all universities are placed in one, located in one place on this globe. And we want to do a very international cool hunt now with people who are not related to a university or do this next to their university relationship. And all the ingredients, all what we've learned, we communicate and we do consultancies with a lot of companies as well here, some of them over the years. Because if you do cool hunting and future forecasting this way, it's not one guy like me saying, hello, I know the future. No, we do it together on three different layers, literature, cool hunting, and the best books. And well, that makes us rather superior, to say it modestly. I want to show you some blocks to see how it works. Some blocks are pretty old, and all these blocks I've selected, because a lot of cool hunters really, really like the blocks. Say, oh, this is totally cool, totally cool, totally cool. And some are pretty stupid, but then there is something behind it. If a lot of people say this is a very cool block, you better listen. This is maybe 10 years old. It was the coolest jeans rated by 3,000 cool hunters that year. It's a jeans with a keypad in your crotch. So you play with your crotch and the internet opens for you. It's cool, it's funny, and it's total nonsense. You can't wash, for example, you can't wash the jeans. So very bad idea. At the same time, when so many people got enthusiastic by the idea, say, oh, this is cool, 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 you must think extra, what's behind these nonsensical genes? And what is behind it? A deep desire, I want to feel connected 24/7, 365. The genes doesn't work, but the desire behind the genes, I want to be connected 24/7, 365. We got a very creative, innovative concept for that, and that's called our mobile phones. This is 12 years old. Mobile phones were not that popular back then. Now they are. And this, for the first time, made us realize what a huge, collective, pulsating, soft spot is hidden behind these genes. A cool seat, hugely cool, considered by our cool hunters. Very stupid idea, but there's something pulsating under it, which is huge. I want to feel connected 24/7, 365. Here, another stupid idea, very romantic and pretty stupid. This is Ingeborg. I come up with the name. So she lived in Denmark, and this is Pablo in Peru. They met each other in Brussels, fell deeply in love, and then both of them had to go back to their own countries. And now when she's going to sleep, softly her pillow lightens up and she hears his heartbeat, and same for Pablo in Peru. Very romantic, very cool, very endearing. And utterly, utterly stupid. Not in the least, because when he is going to sleep, she's getting up in the morning. And when she's going to sleep, he is up in the morning. So nonsense. At the same time, when so many cool hunters say, oh, this is cool, this is interesting, I like it so much, you have to think twice, what's behind it? And can we make a better innovative concept behind it? What's behind this is I want to feel connected all the time with my loved ones. The cushion is very romantic and the pillow is very romantic and rather stupid. But then we got Skype and now we have Zoom. Wherever my loved ones on this world are, I want to feel connected. And now we have very cheap flights as well. So forget the pillow, but under the pillow is pulsating a deeply felt collective need by a lot of people, especially when you are in long distance relationships. So that's the power of cool hunting. This is, I don't know, this original cool seat came from, I thought it was Milano, but I don't know anymore. It's a lady in a solar panel bikini, so she's able to upload the batteries of her mobile to this bikini. Lovely idea. I went all over the globe with these pictures. And they asked the cool hunters, what do you think of it? And especially the girl said, very stupid idea. I'm not the walking battery loader of my boyfriend. So definitely not a big hit. And it looks stupid as well. But also here, when so many people see something in it, say, oh, this is cool, this is interesting, you must think harder what's behind it. And what's basically behind it, wherever I go on this globe, I don't want to lose my battery load of my mobile. So in Finland, when I took this example to Finland, to a tourist school, they say, well, Finland, we love to trek to our sea parts, to our fjords in Norway, but we're very much afraid to lose the battery load on our mobiles, because then we might get lost, and that's no fun here. So forget the bikini, but replace it with another creative, innovative idea to put a solar panel at the back of your backpack. This is how cool hunting goes from creativity to great imaginative examples, overrating how cool do you think this, to innovative concepts. This is Radiate. It's a Kickstarter project, and to be honest, it was very popular 5 years ago. I don't know how the guys are doing right now, but the idea was, if you sport, the colors of your Radiate shirt show you how your body feels, show you your hydration level, your muscle tension. Fantastic idea. To be honest, I don't think it worked out, but the idea was totally cool. And a lot of cool hunters love the idea. And then if so many people love the idea, you hit something. And basically we hit this. Wearables, the ubiquitous rise of wearables all over the world. Thanks, by the way, to the avant-garde of wearable monitoring your own body trend in military industry. So also here you see a simple example, but highly appreciated, collected first by the cool hunters and highly appreciated by the cool hunters. And then it starts to fly. Often you have to change it to use your innovative powers, but we also do that in cool hunting. And then we were one of the first to predict the rise of the monitoring devices on your body. And now they're everywhere, in health, in all kinds of illnesses, but also in fitness, staying healthy. One more example, this is Alireza, one of my students from Donghua University in Shanghai, and he came with a fantastic subject. He said he worked with fashion students, also from Donghua, and he said, let's create a dress for the girls with wearables in it. So the girls go dancing on the dance floor, and when she sees a cool guy, a guy she is erotically interested in, her body reacts, and these body reactions made her dress going transparent. Interesting idea. I ask a lot of the girls, do you like it? To get half naked on the dance floor when you see a nice guy. All girls said, no, definitely not. So also here, a very stupid idea. And at the same time, that idea that grabs your attention. And you could see on the evaluations of this cool seat on the workspaces back then. And then I took this idea, a disco dress, making the ladies naked on the dance floor. How stupid can you go? How can you translate it for hospitality industry? And some of the cool hunters, hospitality cool hunters from Barcelona said, oh, I can. I'm working at a hotel in the inner city of Barcelona. And from time to time, in the middle of the night at 3 o'clock, very drunk, very overheated guys went to the room, drunk and overheated, put the airco on a freezing cold, fall on the bed, freezed way too long because they are half comatose, and sometimes the next morning you have to go to the hospital with a lung infection or with a health problem. So forget the disco dress. But behind the disco dress is a textile that can measure your bodily functioning. So forget the disco dress, but make it a sheet. Make it a sheet in hotels for drunk guys who put on the airco way too high and then get a cold. Suppose you can see, oh, the guy is cooled off enough. The color of the sheet, not the disco dress, but the color of the sheet is high enough. It's tempering down. And then put off, Internet of Things, the airco. So also here, an interesting insight in a very weird way. The disco dress has never become a big hit, but there's something behind it which gives you a lot of opportunities elsewhere. The next example, and it's one but my last, is a great example because I convinced for 5 years companies, already guys, girls, CEOs or marketing departments, Instagram is the future. And I got it from this plate. It's a plate in a Tel Aviv restaurant, and there's a slide in it for your mobile. So before you start eating, you make a pic of your food. I'm not a millennium, I'm not young, so I think it's a little bit stupid, but millennials love it. And it got, some time ago, it got very high ratings in coolant. So also this cool seat I took with me to my universities all over the world, and young people relate to it. And this is the strongest by 3,000 votes that year example of a cool seat that shows something. Hello, we are becoming the Instagrammable generation. So when I want to convince a company to go things on Instagram, this is my cool seat. And it's not one cool seat, it's a cool seat highly appreciated by 3,000 cool hunters all over the world. So that makes it strong. Last example, this is Shiftware. Shiftware is an Australian company with LED screens on the side. So every day you can project from the internet another design on your Shiftware shoes, which is, it hits a lot of different spots, personalization, customization, but also sustainability, simply because you only need one or two pairs of shoes, one for summer, one for winter, and in the meanwhile, you have 1,000 pairs of shoes. This was 1,000 pairs of shoes. This was the third introduction in cool hunting. Now we were talking about the methodology and cool seats. Okay.